Hello and welcome to a new video here on my channel, here at commaik. In this video, I want to show you quickly and concisely how you can easily set up your Reolink cameras on your computer's client or register them in your phone's app. If you want to know how this works, stay tuned, because that's exactly what this video is about. I will show you how to set up the cameras on the client, on your computer and in your phone's app, using a Wi-Fi camera as an example, specifically the Reolink Altus Wi-Fi battery camera. And I'll show you how it works with the wired Reolink Elite X Pro PoE camera. I've already had the chance to test both cameras. If you're interested in these cameras, take a look at the top right corner. There, I'll link you to the videos about the cameras. But now I want to start with the PoE version, the Reolink Elite X Pro PoE. Here, the power supply is provided via the network cable and of course data is also transmitted through it. To connect the camera to the network, I need a network cable. The cable is included in the package, but it's not always the right length. The cable is simply plugged into the network port. The other end is plugged into your router or the switch in your network. The special feature of a PoE camera is that the power supply runs through the regular network cable. This means if you want to use this function, the device on the other end naturally has to supply the power. For that, you need a PoE switch or a PoE injector. You can find out exactly what that is by checking the description below the video. I've linked some information for you there. As soon as the camera is connected, it turns on automatically. With some models, however, you first have to turn the camera on manually on the underside or back. Once it's turned on, you can continue directly on the computer. As soon as I have connected the camera with the network cable and it has booted up, it will automatically appear at the very bottom of the list in the client and just needs to be registered. If it doesn't appear automatically for you, you have the option to add the camera manually using the plus button. In the UID section, the cameras that the system finds in your network are displayed. Here, you can add the camera directly using the plus button. Alternatively, you can of course also enter the camera's IP address. You can usually find the IP address in your router. If neither of these options work, then the camera is not properly registered in the network, or your router is blocking the camera in some way. To register the camera, I click on the tile and I have to set a password. By default, this field is empty. Important for all of you who are running a network video recorder, an NVR in your network. With the latest software updates, the NVR automatically assigns a startup password when it detects a new camera. You must first change or read the startup password directly using the mouse on the NVR screen and then enter it here. I've already done that and will now enter the password in the client's password input field. Afterwards, I confirm the entry, then I immediately see the camera's live image. Of course, you can use the same procedure in the app as well. I've already launched the Reolink app and am in the camera overview. At the very bottom of the overview, the most recently added cameras are automatically displayed. In my case, this also includes the Reolink Elite X Pro PoE. Of course, the camera hasn't been registered yet. Here, at the top right, you have the plus sign to manually register the camera. At this point, you can also use the QR code scanner to scan the camera's QR code and quickly establish a connection. Alternatively, you can manually enter the UID code found on the camera here as well. Or you can scan your network for cameras that the system has automatically detected. In my case, I don't need to do that. The camera was added automatically. I click on the tile and have to enter the password here as well. I confirm the entry. And shortly after, the camera's live image is already displayed for me. Now I can configure the camera settings just like you would on the client. So you see, setting up the PoE camera is incredibly simple. If you have any questions about this, leave me a comment below the video. I'll try to respond as quickly as possible. Now let's move on to the second camera, namely this Wi-Fi camera, the Reolink Altus. Unfortunately, with Wi-Fi cameras, it's not quite as easy to integrate them directly into the network, because here too, there are two variants. In one variant, the cameras also have a cable whip and must first be connected to the system via network cable. This way, you can use the client to set up the Wi-Fi access credentials. That means it works exactly like with a PoE camera. You connect the camera to your router, or switch using the network cable. Then you start the client or the app and enter the password. After that, you go to the network settings. Next, you select your Wi-Fi and enter the network password. Now, in principle, you can access the camera via Wi-Fi. But with this Reolink battery-powered camera, there isn't any cable built in at all. On the other side, I only have the port for USB power supply or the option to insert an SD card. To integrate this camera into my network, I absolutely need the app on my phone and the QR code printed on the camera. I'll show you now how to easily integrate the camera into your network by starting the app. Once the application is open, please tap the plus sign located in the top right corner and then proceed to scan the QR code that is displayed on the camera. As soon as the camera is detected, the system will ask how and with what you want to connect the camera. I've installed the Home Hub and the Home Hub Pro in my network, so I could connect the camera directly to either of these devices. But in this video, I won't be doing that. Instead, I'll be adding the camera as a standalone device. Of course, you can always link it to the Home Hub or Home Hub Pro later on if you wish. You can also connect the powered Wi-Fi cameras to the NVR. Since the Wi-Fi hasn't been configured yet, I'll choose the first option and connect the camera to my network using the Bluetooth function. Of course, Bluetooth must be enabled on your phone for this. An illustrated guide now shows me exactly what I need to do. First, I need to turn on the camera using the power button. Welcome to Reolink. Please install the Reolink app and scan the QR code on the camera. After thoroughly scanning the immediate area via Bluetooth and carefully confirming in the app that I clearly heard the rather loud and distinct voice prompt, I am then automatically taken to the Wi-Fi setup screen. Here I can easily select the preferred Wi-Fi network from the available options and then securely enter the corresponding password for it. After the device has been successfully connected to the Wi-Fi network, I then need to carefully set a secure password and subsequently confirm it once again. After that, the camera is immediately available in my app, and with a click on the tile, I can access the settings and use the camera. The settings menu is also available here, allowing me to fine-tune the camera. After integrating the camera into my network, I naturally want to use it on the client on my computer as well. I restarted the client. This time, the camera was not automatically added to the list. In this case, I select the plus sign, I search for the devices that have already been detected on the network. Here, I scroll down to the camera that has been recognized. You need to be aware that the camera's name is not always displayed. In my case, it says My Device. By clicking the plus sign, the camera is now integrated. Here as well, I need to enter the password. And as you can see, the camera is now registered in my client. I can see that there is no SD card installed yet, and that the Wi-Fi signal is very strong. The battery level is also displayed. Here too, I can adjust the camera settings via the menu. For example, I can modify the video stream. I hope I was able to show you how quickly and easily you can integrate a wired or a Wi-Fi camera into your network. Do you want to know more? For example, how to fine-tune the settings? Do you want to know how to unlock the camera so you can access it on the go using mobile data? Then check below the video. There I've linked my other videos where I explain this in detail. Feel free to leave me a comment under the video so we can exchange ideas with each other. Reolink sponsors the cameras. Check below the video. There you find the promo link and can purchase the cameras. I'll also link the other products there that I'm satisfied with and am happy to recommend. Give my video a like and subscribe to my channel. Remember, by subscribing, you have the chance to win one of the cameras I receive from Reolink. You heard that right. These cameras are regularly raffled off in giveaways. If you want to take part, subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. I'm already looking forward to it. Take care until then.